Hello friends, how are you? Hope you're all healthy and happy. Make sure to watch until the end to catch everything clearly. Have you heard of this XP-49? In the midst of World War II, Lockheed set out to create a fighter that could exceed the already impressive capabilities of the P-38 Lightning, a design so successful it earned the nickname Fork-tailed Devil. This ambitious new project was the XP-49, envisioned as the next generation of air superiority. The Lockheed XP-49 was designed as an enhanced fighter, building on the foundation of the P-38 Lightning. Despite its potential, the project did not advance past the prototype phase. By the time the prototype was completed, it was already surpassed by the operational capabilities of the existing P-38 models. On March 11, 1939, the US Material Division called for submissions for a new interceptor fighter. The Air Corps recommended leveraging existing airframe designs paired with new, more powerful engines to accelerate the development process and achieve higher performance levels. With its sleek lines and advanced features, the XP-49 held the promise of greater speed, firepower, and altitude performance. Yet, despite its potential, the prototype never saw combat. By the time it was ready to take flight, the operational P-38 Lightning had already evolved to meet the demands of war, leaving the XP-49 overshadowed and ultimately shelved. The plan for the production models included Wright R-2160 Tornado engines, capable of producing 2,300 horsepower, complemented by turbo superchargers. This advanced configuration anticipated a top speed of 473 mph at 20,000 feet for the prototype and an impressive 500 mph at the same altitude for the production versions. The inception of the Lockheed XP-49 was rooted in the evolving landscape of aerial warfare during World War II. As nations sought to outdo each other in military capabilities, the demand for superior aerial combat vehicles led to rapid advancements in aircraft technology. The XP-49 project was Lockheed's response to this demand, aiming to enhance the already successful P-38 Lightning with cutting-edge features and performance improvements. During the late 1930s and early 1940s, the Lockheed P-38 Lightning had established itself as a formidable aircraft, known for its distinctive twin boom design, speed, and versatility. Fast-paced advancements in aviation technology and the increasing demands of the war necessitated the development of an even more advanced fighter. The United States Army Air Corps, USAAC, recognizing the need for superior high-altitude interceptors, solicited proposals from aircraft manufacturers for a new generation of fighters. Lockheed, with its successful track record and the proven effectiveness of the P-38, was keen to build upon its expertise. The company proposed an aircraft that would not only surpass the P-38's performance, but also incorporate the latest advancements in aviation technology. While retaining the distinctive twin boom configuration of the P-38, the XP-49 was planned to feature several design optimizations. These included aerodynamic refinements, increased fuel capacity for extended range, and a more streamlined fuselage to enhance its speed and agility. Focus on high-altitude performance. Recognizing the strategic advantage of high-altitude interceptors, Lockheed designed the XP-49 to excel in this domain. The aircraft was to feature a pressurized cockpit, a relatively new innovation that would allow the pilot to operate effectively at altitudes unreachable by most contemporary fighters. The ambitious nature of the XP-49 project meant that Lockheed faced significant technical and engineering challenges. The cutting-edge technologies and the untested innovations incorporated into the design brought with them innovations in the XP-49. The aircraft industry was still in a period of rapid development, with many new technologies and materials only just emerging from experimental stages. The XP-49 was developed during a period of intense wartime pressure, where the demand for superior military equipment was balanced against the urgent need for quick production and deployment. Lockheed was tasked with creating an aircraft that not only pushed the boundaries of existing technology, but also could potentially be produced in sufficient numbers to meet the demands of the war effort. The Lockheed XP-49's design and development phase was a concerted effort to push the boundaries of what was technically feasible in an aircraft, building on the reputable foundations laid by the P-38 Lightning. Lockheed aimed to create a fighter that not only exceeded the performance characteristics of its predecessors, but also set new standards in aviation technology, particularly in the realm of high-altitude interception. The XP-49 was envisioned as a beacon of advanced engineering, with its design centered around the incorporation of the Pratt & Whitney X-1800 engines, which promised unparalleled performance. These engines were expected to endow the aircraft with superior speed, an impressive service ceiling, and robust climbing capabilities, essential attributes for dominating aerial combat. The shift to the less potent R2800 engines, however, was a pivotal moment in the aircraft's development, significantly affecting its anticipated superiority by diminishing its projected performance advantages. In addition to power plant considerations, the XP-49 embodied a series of advanced design features aimed at ensuring operational excellence. The pressurized cockpit was a notable innovation, intended to provide pilot comfort and efficacy at high altitudes, thereby extending the aircraft's operational envelope. This feature was a forward-thinking addition, recognizing the shifting combat theaters to higher altitudes and the corresponding need for enhanced pilot endurance and aircraft performance. Aerodynamic efficiency was paramount in the XP-49's design, with Lockheed's engineers striving to refine the aircraft's contours for optimal airflow, reduced drag, and improved stability. The XP-49 was also intended to carry an advanced armament suite, capable of delivering formidable firepower. Integrating such a heavy and complex armament array without compromising the aircraft's performance was a significant challenge. It required innovative solutions to maintain the balance of the aircraft, ensure ease of access for maintenance, and optimize the weapon systems for combat efficiency. Throughout the design and development process, the XP-49 was subjected to a rigorous regime of testing, including wind tunnel tests and a range of ground evaluations. These tests were critical for validating the design choices, ensuring the aircraft could achieve the intended performance metrics, and identifying any potential issues that could hinder operational effectiveness. The decision to halt the XP-49 project was not taken lightly. It was the culmination of various technical, strategic, and operational evaluations weighed against the backdrop of an industry rapidly transitioning towards jet-powered aircraft. The termination of the XP-49 project can be attributed to a confluence of factors. Primarily, the performance of the XP-49, while impressive in certain respects, did not sufficiently exceed the capabilities of the existing P-38 Lightning to justify its continued development, especially considering the necessary compromises following the engine substitution. The aircraft's inability to meet the lofty expectations set forth at its inception, particularly regarding its speed and high-altitude capabilities, played a crucial role in assessing its feasibility as a frontline interceptor. Moreover, the rapid advancement in aviation technology, especially the onset of jet propulsion, rendered propeller-driven designs like the XP-49 increasingly obsolete. The emerging jet fighters demonstrated superior performance metrics that piston-engined aircraft could not match, particularly in terms of top speed, rate of climb, and operational ceiling.